With shared libraries in Webflow, you can share and use components and variables from one site across an entire workspace. And the best part, updates to the main components and variables from the original source of truth can also be updated across the workspace. This is super useful when you have multiple sites for one company and you can maintain brand consistency across those sites. We're going to cover shared libraries in 6 parts. We'll start by showing how to share a library, then how to install and use a library within a new site, then pushing and accepting updates to that library, how to convert to a site component, uninstalling a library, and last but not least, we'll unshare a library. First part, sharing a library. Here's a Webflow site with components that have been built to fit a company's brand, and they're all using variables. This is a good practice when it comes to creating a library. It's good to have one site where your design system lives to house the main components and variables. This site is just for internal use. It's just the source of truth for our components and variables. To share a library, we can go into either the Variables panel or the Components panel and click Manage Libraries. And here, we can see the option to share this site's library. And quick note, this site's library is named after the site itself, so keep that in mind when you're naming and organizing your sites. Ours is okay for now, so let's move forward to share with the workspace and click Share Library. Done. Library shared. Next part. Here I am in a blank site, and I need to create a new website using the same components and variables to match the company's brand. Same place, go to either the Components or Variables panel to manage our libraries. And we want to install the library that was just shared. And once we do, once it's finished installing, we can see all of the components and all of the variables from the source site, the site these components and variables were originally created. And now we can just use them however we want to build and style our site. We can even change properties of a component to better fit the site. And something you'll probably notice, we cannot edit the main components or variables. That's because they're only editable from the source site. So let's do that. Here we are back in our source site, and let's make some changes to this navbar component. We'll make the banner stand out by changing this variable, and let's also create a property on this CTA button so we can change it to fit with whatever page it's on. Now, to push these updates, go back to Manage Libraries, Review Updates. Here are the changes we just made to the component and variable, then Share Updates. And now those updates have been successfully shared to the rest of the workspace. Have we updated that library everywhere now? Not just yet. We still need to accept those updates on the sites that used the library. So here's that previous site we were building before, and we can see that there are updates to that library. If we go in, we can review that library and accept those changes. And just like that, the library has been updated, and all instances of my navbar component have been updated as well. And I can edit the content on this new property to better fit this site. Now, that was pushing and accepting updates. What about converting to a site component? What does this mean? Converting to a site component means it will create a duplicate of a library component and is only available locally to this site, meaning you won't be able to use it on another site within the workspace. This is useful if you want to separate it from the library and make your own edits to that component. But keep in mind, any updates to that component in the library will not sync to the site component because it's only editable on this site. It's no longer connected to the library. So let's see what that looks like. In our source site, let's delete that property from this navbar component. So now the main component no longer has the button text property. Share updates, now the library is updated. Back to our other site, when you go in to review the updates, since we used the button text property on this component here, we have the option to accept the updates or convert to a site component. Accepting the update means that that component property will be removed on all instances of that component along with any edits. This may work for some, but if you want to keep your property edits, you can convert this to a site component. And once we do, we can see in the Components panel under Site Components, there's that navbar component, and all instances of that component throughout our site are now using the site component. But at any time, you can right-click on a library component and convert it to a site component. And doing so will convert that instance to a site component. In addition, site components and variables are automatically created when a component or variable that's being used on a site is deleted from a library. All right, home stretch. Next thing we're going to do is uninstall a library on a site. In our site, same place, but instead, we're going to hover over and uninstall the library. And nothing is lost when you uninstall. Site components and variables are created for any library content used on your site. That way, you can keep building your site with the components and variables you used. And the final part, how to unshare a library. And doing this is super quick. Back in our source site, when we're managing our library, instead of going in to share the updates, we're just going to unshare, then confirm. Now this library can no longer be installed on any site within the workspace. But other sites that have already installed that library can still use them until they're ready to uninstall. And that's it. There's so much more to libraries, like marketplace libraries, created by some of our awesome designers and developers in the community, and you can learn more about using those and some best practices over at Webflow University. But that's shared libraries in Webflow.